الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله، أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانا وأفصحها بيانا، فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة، صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده، خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. O believers, mu'mins, this is a Friday where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam honored him with Friday to be a holiday for Muslims. A holiday for mu'mins, a holiday for the whole universe. It was not important Friday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not reveal it to his Prophet to be a holiday where there will be a united unity between Muslims coming together and listening to each other and performing the prayer. Allah wants Muslims to be together where he said, Yadullahi ma'al jama'ah, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that Allah's hand means Allah's blessings are under Allah, under human being are under Allah's blessings. Wherever there is a gathering, that gathering is, if it is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for his Prophet, it is a good gathering. And this is a good gathering that we are here every Friday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every masjid, bless every Muslim that they come together and pray their prayers in a jama'ah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has his companions, the righted khalifa, the khalifas that were only for truth, the khalifa of Muslims, not only 40 khalifa, four khalifa, which are the major ones, but every companion of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a khalifa of Prophet. And the evidence of that is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying in a hadith that sahabati kan nujum bi ayyihim iqtadaytum ihtadaytum. My sahaba, my companion, are like guided stars. Stars that they guide you at night. They are stars. And what kind of stars? When he say stars, we have to think. Why Prophet mentioned his sahaba as stars? Because it's very simple. If a little bit we expand the features of a star, then we can understand why Prophet said about his Sahaba like that, which is something unique for the Sahaba, not for everyone, but it is so immense that we cannot know its beginning and we cannot know its end. When he says, my sahaba, my companions are like stars, we know that stars in real life, astronomy, stars are bigger, might be, than this whole solar system, one star. One star might be bigger than all our system that we are living in, including The sun, Mars, Jupiter, Venus, all of them. It's one system. One star, in astronomy or physics, says that one star is bigger, so huge. There are stars so huge that they cannot understand their greatness, how big they are. So Prophet wants to tell us that, my companion, if you follow one, بأيهم اقتديتم, anyone you choose and you follow, you will be guided, because they are stars. Since they are stars, means we cannot know how big of knowledge that Prophet gave to them. Because Prophet, Allah gave him علوم الأولين والآخرين, the knowledge of before, knowledge of after. Means the knowledge of Holy Quran. Since Prophet say, I have been given the knowledge of before, knowledge of after, and the knowledge came through Holy Quran, means the Holy Quran, as we know, of course, is not a book that even created. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's own words. Means something belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, own words are not created, are only attributes that describe His greatness. So Holy Quran is an attribute. That's one, no one can touch it when he has no wudu. That's why someone is not ready, clean to touch it, cannot touch it. Because it is an attribute, if we can say that. Because it's Allah's word. Like Al-Alim, Al-Khaliq, Al-Rahman, Al-Rahim, Al-Quddus, whatever different beautiful names and attributes, the Holy Quran is not one attribute, but I cannot say a star of attributes, but it is the Holy Quran is no beginning, no end. That's why Sahaba, when they learned from Prophet, علوم الأولين, what is علوم الأولين? Allah created, Allah did not create the Holy Quran. We cannot say that. In Islam, if anyone say Quran is created, is outside the realm of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. It's outside. It's outside of Islam. Means like the attributes, it has no beginning because Allah has no beginning. And no end because Allah has no end. What this description of beautiful name and attributes are with Him, are describing Him. So the Holy Quran is describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in different ways. And that's why the first surah of Holy Quran is begin with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to Allah, the creator of humans, angels and jinn. To show the greatness of that, he is praising himself by himself. He is not in need for our praises. He said, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. I'm praising myself to myself, by myself. So, from where there is no beginning, Prophet got this علوم الأولين. Means before human being were created, Quran was there. Because it is Allah's word. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a strong hadith, he said, I was a prophet and Adam between clay and water. كنت نبيا وآدم بين الماء والطين. أو كنت نبيا وآدم بين الروح والجسد. I was a prophet when Adam was between clay and water. So means prophet was prophet. Prophet on whom? Prophet on what Allah wants him to be prophet on. We don't know. But he was prophet before Adam alayhi salam. That's why he said, Adam woman dunahu tahta liwa'i yawm al-qiyamah. Adam and who is under Adam are under my flag in the day of judgment. And Allah ordered Adam, if prophet comes in your time, you be following him. And all other prophets. So what he, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah taught him from knowledge of no beginning, when there is no beginning, from these knowledges. He said, Allah gave me Ulum al-Awwaleen. And what is Ulum al-Awwaleen? It's the Holy Quran. Allah said in Surah Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahman, Allama al-Quran, Khalaq al-Insan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His beautiful name, Ar-Rahman, Allama al-Quran, taught the Holy Quran. There was no creation because he said in the surah Khalaq al-Insan after that. Ar-Rahman, Allam al-Quran, Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allam al-Quran, taught the Quran, Khalaq al-Insan, created a human being. So who is there between the sifat al-alim wal-ilm? Allah has the beautiful name al-alim. Through that beautiful name and through the Al-Khaliq, there was ta'lim, there was knowledge there, that he taught it to someone. Who is that someone? Ar-Rahman, Allam al-Quran, Khalaq al-Insan. Between Al-Alim, Sifat al-Alim, attribute of Al-Alim, between Sifat and the other one, Sifat al-Khaliq, Creator, there is ta'lim, there is knowledge. He taught someone. To whom? And Prophet say, he said, I was a prophet, and Adam between clay and water. I was a prophet, and Adam between al-ruh wal-jasad, the soul and the body. So who then learned that? It's Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. His prophet. Allah taught him in the life when he created him as a prophet in paradise. And Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they agree on that. So no one can be denying the power of prophet that Allah, what he has taught him. So what he taught him, he taught his Sahab. That's why he said, Ashabi kan nujum, my companions are like stars. He didn't say Ashabi mudarrisin, Ashabi teachers, Ashabi my companions, warriors. He didn't say that, Prophet ﷺ. He said, my Sahaba, my companions, are like stars. Do we like to look at stars? Everyone likes to look at stars. Can you be there? No. Sahaba were there. Not physically sitting in the star, standing, but it is a metaphoric, you see, it is explanation, interpretation, that they are so immense in their knowledge, that their knowledge cannot be given except to them. What Prophet ﷺ gave his Sahaba did not give us. First of all, why they've been honored, Sahaba? Because they heard Prophet. Did we hear Prophet? No. We learned about Prophet from one said this, then the other, and the other, and the other, until it came to us. So we did not, we are not like Sahaba heard Prophet, sat with Prophet, ate with Prophet, heard him reciting Quran. No. What kind of a voice that Prophet has? What kind of beauty that Prophet has? What kind of strength and power that Prophet has? If Sahaba are like stars, and he described them that, what he is then? What is he then? Is he a star? Or he is a universe? If he is a universe of knowledge, is it a complete or a real explanation that he is a universe, which us, our universe that we are seeing, consists of 6,000 galaxies, and our dunya 80 billion stars in this galaxy, in one galaxy? Is he a universe? If Sahaba are stars, then Prophet is encompassing them. Then is a universe. But he was not only a universe, he was ascended to Qaba Qawsayn aw Adna. If he is a universe, he cannot ascend in paradises in dunya. But he ascended. Allah called him, invited him. He was able to come up. So what he was then? Like me and you? Like his Sahaba? No way. Allah gave him ulum al-awwalin wal-akhirin, knowledge that no one can understand. Is a moon, as people they say, reflecting the light of sun? Is he the sun reflecting that light? Like sun reflects light, is he a sun? Is he universe? Or but more Allah gave to him? Allah gave, showing his greatness in Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That human being, I'm raising up him up to Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna. Can anyone raise him? No one. Where is Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna? How far, how much is so near to the presence, divine presence? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, divine presence. No one can reach. Even Prophet. Still there is, Allah said, Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna, two bows of an arrow, means two hands, two arms, nearness, or less, he said. But no one can be in the real divine presence. Little bit distinguish him from as a servant of Allah, and Allah is the creator. Prophet, yes, is a servant of Allah, and he is happy to be called servant. With all what Allah gave to him, look, today, not today, in every, in history, someone, Fir'aun, what he said, when he saw Egypt of, the people of Egypt are, he is suppressing them. He said, "Ana Rabbukum al-A'la. I am your highest God. No one above me. No, I am the God. I am God. Ana Rabbukum al-A'la." Because out of arrogance, he think himself he became something. What you think about Sahaba when a Prophet says to them, "You are stars." In dark nights, still they were humble. What do you think about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who went to Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna? Most humble. And what he said, "Ya Rabbi, Don't leave me to my ego for a blink of an eye. اللهم لا تكني إلى نفسي طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك. That's big. Oh Allah, don't leave me to myself, to my ego. The Prophet has ego. Hasha. To myself for a blink of an eye or less. Mean less than a blink of an eye, don't leave me to myself. I will be lost in your greatness. No, with no atom or zarra in Arabic, the most smaller of an atom today, they are finding smaller than an atom, micron, cannot even to that extent. If I am going to be left to myself, I lose myself. I lose, Ya Rabbi, I will be a loser. Hey, what about us? We are arrogant. We are arrogant in our actions. We do not try to make peace together. We are not trying to unite together. If someone open a mosque here, they say, why he open a mosque? Increase mosques. Every street in there is a mosque is better. Don't make a problem out of it, why they have more mosques. Is enough our mosque in the area? No. It is not. Sahaba built mosques everywhere. They made their homes mosques. They made their homes restaurants, in the meaning of restaurant today. They opened their homes for anyone coming through the street, not finding a shelter. They give him a shelter, they give him food for 3 days, and they ask him what you can help you. They never look at someone homeless in a bad eye. They never look at someone who is not a Muslim in a bad eye. They look at everyone with complete faith that this is a human being like us. There is no difference. When someone asked me in an interfaith program, I didn't have an answer so quick. They asked, yani, what is the problem the interfaith people are meeting together to know each other? But sometimes there are frictions. Yes, there are. Who makes the frictions? Is this head? If you take your head out, all of you are same. Any difference? No difference. The head, what makes us different? Means every problem is here. Is ego. The ego is in the heart, is in the mind. The heart is clean. Because Allah said, مَا وَسِعَتْنِي سَمَائِي وَلَا أَرْضِي وَلَكِنْ وَسِعَانِي قَرْبَ عَبْدِي الْمُؤْمِنِ in a holy hadith, that neither my heavens nor my earth contain me, but the heart of the believer contain me. So means the heart can contain the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not the mind. The mind is too much. I want to do this, I want to do that, you will never see Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in whole the Holy Quran or Hadith, he said, La. No. Never he said no to anyone. Always submitting to what is needed. He never said something that make people unhappy. O Muslims, O believers, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we go back to the first of the hadith. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, follow my Sahaba, you will be guided. They are stars in dark nights. What in dark nights? You cannot see the star now. Cannot see the stars now. Daytime. Cannot see them. But you can see them in the night and in dark nights. Because daytime, there is light shining. Means when the light shine in the heart of the believer, the dark nights means the darkness from the heart of the believer will go away. And only there is a sun. And that sun is the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He manifests on you, the beautiful names, An-Nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Nur. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. Allah is the light. Means His beautiful name, An-Nur, dress the whole universe and the whole heavens and paradises. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. Allah, the light of heavens and earth. Okay, since Allah is the light of heavens and earth, what we can benefit? If we are on the right side, we are under that light. If we are on the wrong side, we are under the darkness of shaitan. So you want to be with the darkness, or you want to be with the light? Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard, He is the light of heavens and earth. Means He will shine your light on you. And then you become a star. He shines that light on Sahaba of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why he described them Prophet like stars. Different shining stars that you can look at them. And when you look at them, you say, Subhanallah. Do you want to be like that? Yes. Allah said in Holy Quran, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Allah has put under your control what is in heavens, what is in earth, everything. See? Means, اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If you want to be the light of heavens and earth, Allah gave you that by saying in the another verse, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ. He put under your control السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, heavens and earth. But go for it. يا معشر الجن والإنس إن استطعتم أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا. Oh human beings and jinn, you want to penetrate from this universe and from heavens to my presence? Yes, do that. I gave you. انفذوا. Do it. Do it by making that light to shine in your heart by following what Prophet came with. فَانْفُذُوا. Try to penetrate. لَا تَنْفُذُونَ. Then he immediately say, no, you will not be able to do it. You can, I gave you the permissibility, I gave you the allowance, go in, no problem. But you want it? لَا تَنْفُذُونَ إِلَّا بِسُلْطَان. You cannot penetrate without a sultan. Sultan has many meanings here. But we go with one meaning. لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان. Sultan here is Sultan al-Sharia. This, to follow what Allah likes and loves. And Allah described it, what He loves and likes. إن كنتم تحبون الله. If you love me, really likes me, and I want to love you, فاتبعوني. قل يا محمد. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. If you really love Allah, follow Muhammad, Allah loves you. So it is our duty to what? To follow. To follow the way. To follow whom? To follow Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet make it easy for us. He said, you want to be guided? Look at the stars. Take any one of my Sahaba and follow his way. It takes you to my way. Look how much merciful is Prophet. One person came to him, he said, Ya Rasulullah, قَدْ كَثُرَتْ عَلَيَّ شَرَائِعِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Too much principles in Islam is to become, I am very heavy with that, I cannot do it. Too much. Many, there are many, cannot do them all. Prophet said, يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. Make everything easy, don't make it difficult. Why to make difficult to people when you see their capacity, they cannot do it, fulfill it, you are pushing them to do it. They cannot do it. There are many in today, people look at a mistake from you. Why? We are ma'soom, infallible? No. We are not ma'soom. So what he said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that yassiru wa la tu'assiru, make some things easy, don't make it difficult. Like you go to Hajj. They say to you, you cannot throw these stones, these pebbles, at this time it has to be after Zuhur. Ulama came with a fatwa that you can't do it because today, if you don't do it at that time, before Zuhur, for example, preferable for Zuhur, but if you cannot do it, yassiru wa la tu'assiru. الضرورات تبيح المحظورات. Necessity will waive the forbidden. So if it is forbidden, do it. Allah is saying, I'm raising it. It's a principle in Islam. So you cannot say, don't do it. With all these millions of people, how many die from that if they are going to go all in one time? So they came, okay, don't. Do it, delay it, and it's accepted. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to that man who came to him when he said, Ya Rasulullah, too much principles. Do this, do this, do this, do this, do this. I cannot do them all. Give me something easy. He said, اجعل لسانك رطبا بذكر الله. Make your tongue wet with zikrullah. Means remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and keep your tongue moving. When you move you talk, you saliva came to your mouth and your tongue gets wet. He said, make your tongue wet means don't backbite. You cannot do them, but don't make sense by backbiting. Make your tongue to say Allah, or La ilaha illallah, whatever you want. O Muslims, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, and may Allah bless us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه، فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم، مفخر العرب والعجم، مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد. يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته، صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والكافرين. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، سلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على السلاح، حي على السلاح، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم ربنا رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة على سيدنا محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة والدرجة الرفيعة العالية والعطر. اللهم يا رب مقام محمود الذي وعدت انك لا تخلف الوعد، وارزقنا شفاعته يوم القيامة. استووا. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى، سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى، فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإذا ربك فارغب. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين. سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ربنا تقبل منا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا إلى الحق وإلى طريق المستقيم وانصرنا على القوم المفسدين. اللهم أصلح شأننا وشأن المسلمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم عافنا وعاف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. تفضل الله.
Assalamu alaikum. The time is changing for this week. So inshallah the next Juma, next week Juma will be 1:15 we will call the first Adhan and 1:30 the second Adhan and then followed by Khutbah and Salat inshallah. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
سبحانك يا عظيم سبحان الله دائما الحمد لله تعالى شأنه ولا إله غيره الله أكبر كبيرا واحدا لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان ربي العلي العظيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم اجعله ولقائنا هذا صلاحا وأوسطه فلاحا وآخره نجاحا اللهم اجعل أوله رحمة وأوسطه نعمة وآخره تكريما ومغفرة الحمد لله الذي توضع كل شيء لعظمته دل كل شيء لعزته وخضع كل شيء لملكه واستسلم كل شيء لقدرته الحمد لله الذي سكن كل شيء لهيبته وأدار كل شيء بحكمته وتصور كل شيء لكبريائه اللهم اكرمنا في أحب الساعة إليك يا ودود يا ذا العرش المجيد وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الفاتحة
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى
حضرات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عليه وصحبه الكرام وحي أبائنا وأمهاتنا حضرات أستاذنا أستاذ أستاذنا الصديقين الفاتحة
Needs 5 minutes.
Okay. 5 minutes. Sit. anyone is busy to go, you can go. Free. Bring that, and bring one mic.
Alhamdulillah, with your dua, became more than the stars of the night, the moon itself came out.
Come do the Jum'a here. Give the suhbah, give the lecture. Give the...
Do my best, inshallah.
You are doing it somewhere else?
In Washington.
No, in Washington. Whenever you are free. Now Sheikh Ahsan is doing here. We pulled him from where he was. Working now. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Tell them to sing. One song of the sing. You are ready?
No.
Oh, is that ready? Why you need all these chairs?
I need to put this on.
He said 5 minutes, that's like
10 minutes.
20 minutes. How are you? Good?
Well.
More babies? Two. One boy, one girl, is enough. For now, Ali.
That's all we can handle. That's all we can handle.
He said no. Ready?
No.
It's going to take time, never mind.
Huh?
Never mind. MashaAllah, Sheikh Qamar al-Huda here. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
He's the moon.
MashaAllah.
Qamar al-Huda.
Allahu Akbar.
Guided moon. Look at him, you'll be guided. How is work?
Alhamdulillah, very busy.
Ah, very busy. Always busy in this country, this thing's busy. Peace here, peace there, institute there, spending money. Collect taxes, spending them.
Allah.
You are still on this hack?
Yes, sir.
This is on?
They have to keep watching you.
No sound.
I can turn off. No sound.
make the taste of pain and fight and war, make you and the other opponent, we have to make you to taste that in every moment, in every time. So that's what Allah did not accept. Did not accept with his Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Muhammad, when he asked, Ya Rabbi, don't give, I ask you three things. One of them, he accepted two, the third one, this one, to fight each other, he said, no, I'm making them to fight each other. No one can stop who? From Adam alayhi salam, Habil and Qabil. And then count till today. Who can stop that? No one can stop it. So all this is trying to minimize as much, but no one can terminate it. That will not happen on earth. It's impossible. If we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of us, then it will stop. If they are going to still fight, they are going to stop. Because Allah wants everyone to feel the suffering of their amal, of their deeds. كلما جاءت أمة لعنت أختها. Allah said in Holy Quran, every nation comes or every party comes, curse the one before. So everyone cursing everyone. Show that we are driving in the universe. May Allah forgive us.
Amen.
And make us happy with our children, our families, our brothers, our sisters in Islam, inshallah.
Hello.
It's gonna be the wire.
The wire? Okay. He is trying to make a reverb and make the sound nicer. Our sound system engineer.
No, I can't connect to that one. So. Yeah, unless he wants to talk.
Kamarul Huda comes, it's here. Okay, then.
It's your opportunity to ask the questions you wanted to ask. He has a whole bunch of things he wanted to ask you. I said, when you see Sheikh sitting free, take your time. Take your chance.
No, the situation is they can ask you when you are going. MashaAllah, Sheikh, your turban bigger than your head. What happened with your beard? Doesn't grow?
Maybe I have a little Asian.
Might be. Why not? Ask. He's from Senegal. He's from Ghana.
Ghana?
Yeah. But Ghana speaks English, Senegal French.
French, yeah. Comment ça va?
Ça va très bien, oui.
Non, c'est bien.
Merci.
Test? We are under test every moment. What happened?
I just make sure I could hear myself.
This is 5 minutes, is how?
No, he said 5:10. I took the low.
like this in the wall over there where it says left front?
Hey, what are the questions, Sheikh Kamaluddin? One question.
Maybe others have more important questions.
No. Don't worry.
You answered many in your khutbah, in your beautiful khutbah. It's a question going on for even before us, but sectarian violence is very strong within our Islamic community, as you see, Sunni Shia, Sunnah. So if you have any guidance on those, what to do, first to think, then to do, to decrease some of the sectarian problems you see between Sunni and Shia.
I think with the situation in Iran now, and the power in the hand of Wilayat al-Faqih is going to escalate. they come, why you want to hear them?
I don't want, if they go in the wires, and I can, one will reach, if you want to do one.
This one, enough.
But.
You want two or one? This will reach you. Come.
Yeah.
This will go then.
Okay.
But the sound is not good on this one.
It's not coming, hit it, Ali.
Hit it, Ali.
You just have to hold that one close to your face.
Say something, how can you speak in the wire?
Hello, testing.
Speak in the wire,
Mom. Testing.
Wire, Mom.
Testing.
Say
something again.
Okay, sing a
little bit. الحشر سلينا لواهه تلقى من الغيب مجرد حكمة بها أمطارا في الخافقين سماؤه بها أمطارا في الخافقين سماؤه ومشهد أهل الحق منه لطائف تخبر أن المجد واش وشاؤه فلله ما للعين من مشهد اجتلا يعز على أهل حجاب اجتلاؤه هو النور يا للحائرين دياؤه وفي الحشر ذل النور سلينا لواؤه تلقى من الغيب مجرد هكمة في قيل سماؤه بها أمطرت في الخاف في قيل سماؤه فيا رب شارحني برؤية سيدي وأجل صدى القلب الكثير صداؤه عليه صلاة الله ما حبت الصحبة وما أكرم الهادي فطاب هداه هو النور يهدي الهائرين ضياؤه وفي العشر ذل النور سلينا لواؤه تلقى من الغيب مجرد هكمة بها أمطرت في الخوف في قيل سماؤه بها أمطرت في الخوف في قيل سماؤه
It's a large plate with a I have it all. Yeah, it's a reverb echo. It's a plate echo, so it's a reverb.
Okay, that's good. What happened? For singing, it's not good.
zikr too, you want?
Zikr also. Because when you do zikr, it comes and his sound to the thank you.
Yeah, because these guys, they don't say anything.
They are sleeping. يا الله بسم الله إلى حضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وصحبه الكرام وأحيا بين أمهاتنا حضرة أستاذنا أستاذ سلمنا وصديقنا الفاتحة. We are honored today with Kamar al-Huda. Thank you very much for coming. يا الله
Oh, that's what, okay, good. We need that sometime on Saturday.